So, good morning guys. I have decided to upgrade my network attached storage. I have a Synology 21 something J in my closet, but it's almost full. It's already 5 years old, maybe longer even, maybe even 6 or 7, I don't know. I think it's 2 terabytes or something, but I need more space because of all the pictures and video and all kinds of stuff from my kids and for the footage from work, for the vlog, just backup. I have lots of stuff on Dropbox now, but I would like to move it to my own network attached storage or NAS. And maybe make an offsite backup solution on another location, maybe a house or I have to be decided. So what did I buy? For now I bought a Drobo 5, and it's a solution for 5 drives. It has the option to put in a PCI SSD card, which is actually mSATA, which I also bought. It accelerates the cache of the read and write speeds of the NAS. So then you can just use not super fast drives, but then it caches like 250 gigs on the mSATA drives, which I think is a good solution. Also, the less spinning rotations per minute the disk has, the less I think it will fail in the longer term. So lower spinning disks, in my opinion, will last longer, because they obviously make less rotations in the longer period of time, so why wouldn't they last longer? But maybe it's an assumption, but it sounds good to me. Also bought the Seagate NAS, 4 gigs 3 times, and I have a bunch of other drives laying around. The Drobo solution allows you to put in all kinds of drives on sizes. They don't have to match. It is smart enough to figure out a sort of a Drobo rate to make it safe, and to always be sure that there is one drive that can fail. You can also set it to 2 drive fail, but I think that is a bit too much for me. I'm going to set it up with 1 drive fail and an offsite backup on another location, which is then very slow, but doesn't matter if it's a total chaos and mayhem, or if somebody breaks into my house or my house gets burned down and the Drobo is totally gone, then I still need to have these files on another location. So and so do you, of course. Let it be a warning. You have to have local storage and human error failure and basically break-in or other kinds of failures. So make sure you have that set up. Open, open, open. Simsalabim. I bought this on Amazon in Germany. I'm a bit reluctant to buy stuff on Amazon in the UK since a while, because of the Brexit kind of thing. I'm kind of moving my buying stuff over to Germany. Also the CVP, if they don't come up with a smart solution, then I don't think I'm gonna buy stuff in England anymore. So, the Drobo 5, and you see, you can see the box. It's a black unit. It has 5 LEDs on the top and some indicators on the bottom. Yeah, it doesn't say anything. It's sealed, as you can see. So, let's cut it open. Always nice as boxes are sealed, actually. So, welcome to the world of... welcome to the world of bang. Trouble. They actually like their packaging loose and stickers and everything and a power brick. All kinds of plugs. A European plug, which I need. And a network cable. This is how to install your Drobo. I can probably figure it out myself. These things always start with download new firmware, download software, and hook this thing up to your computer, and flash the thing with new firmware. Make it a spot okay before you insert any drive, because yeah, they always need new firmware. Another smart tip is when you buy the hard drives, make sure that they are not all created in the factory in the same run, because as you can see, these two hard drives, let's see if it focuses, have numbers that are iterating, and I have the same hard drive also with a much higher number. So, which means is that the chances are high that these drives will probably fail around the same time and not at the same time as the other drive. So if they already in the three, they all three were in the same batch time, then I would be it's not safe if you do that. So try to get another drive. Here's the mSATA unit. Try to open that. It's nothing more than a little piece of silicone, which is 250 gigs of SSD. As you can see, it's nicely packed up together. And it is, but so on top there is some kind of, how should I pronounce it? It's a bag, actually. I don't really know why, but there's a bag over it. It's a nice bag, but it's a shopping bag. It's not like I'm going to use it to go to clients or anything. Now, this is it. Just looks like a metallic box or a computer, if you will. Here is the shopping bag. Now, what is it? Has it on the back? A network jack, a power port, and an on-off switch. So it doesn't involve much. Now, let's turn it over again. I can pop this off. This is magnetic. And you can see what it reads here. All the statuses of the Drobo are optional, and are mentioned what happens when is the drive in danger and all kinds of stuff. It's self-explanatory. I don't think I have to mention it. Just read it, and it will be fine. This is what the Drobo looks like. And you got these flaps here, and in these flaps you can mount hard drives. So you see, it's you don't need to You don't need to do anything. You can just swap them in. There's no caddies or mountain brackets or anything. It's just all pop, pop, pop in and out, which is very nice, I would say. Now, in the bottom, there's this little MSATA thing. You see? I popped it open. Now let's take the MSATA drive. I don't even think I need the screws for it, because here's the MSATA drive. Now let's take a quick look how it needs to be in. It's very simple, because the small end needs to be on this side. So let's pop it in. Okay, it's in. Now let's hook it up again. All very simple, no fuss. I think this is one of the smartest things of the drawer. It's very easy to do. It has a very safe system. I don't even think it's the most expensive one that I could buy. I looked at Synology and QNAP systems with similar drives and stuff, and they all end up like in the same spec. My Synology has a big app store, which this one doesn't, but it has the apps that I want to, which is Plex, and I want to be able to run AirSync on the machine, which is probably doable by going into it and make another cron job with AirSync, and then I use AirSync to basically copy all the stuff over to another location every night with a little bash script, and then it's done. I don't need any apps for it. I just can cook it up myself and it works. So it does Time Machine backup, and I can backup PCs from Windows 10 with internal software to this machine as well. So now I'm gonna hook it up to my computer. So this is the Drobo dashboard. It has found my Drobo 5N. I'm going to select it. Now let's see what it... you see that it's already upgrading to the latest firmware. It's kind of quick. The Drobo itself blinks and flashes to show that it's upgrading. I'll show you. See, it's blinking and flashing quite heavily. It will take 5 minutes, so let's wait. So, and we're back. The Drobo says to me that I need to insert hard drives, which is not that strange, because there aren't any. I'm going to click it. It says Cricut Critical, add a drive, the firmware. Let me double check if that's the latest one. Yes, it is, so it's okay. Hot data cache. Why does it say that the hot data cache is off? Because it should be on. Check for updates. Let's see if it's sure is the latest one. Okay. Okay. Status. Drive information. Network information. Now, as you can see, this is the IP address on which it is now. I will configure it to a different IP when I found which one I want to have it on. But it could be this one. Port speed is a gig. Full duplex. My gateway and DNS server, which is always Google. Looks good. Let me get the drives. So, the drives. I am going to put them in. And the one with the lowest number is going on top. So that I know that that probably is the oldest drive. Not that handy, huh? That's how it goes. One in. It's spinning up. Now the second one. Just put it in and see what happens. You really need to make sure that you pop them in until the end, because the top one, I had to push it a little bit further than I thought was needed. But these things need to be on the original spot, because otherwise they're not in deep enough. It currently sees two drives. Oh, it says already that there are 3-4 terabyte drives in. All the conditions are good. Ah. There it is. Status. Network information. Seems to be all right now. Here are the green lights. Here's the network light, which blinks once in a while. Power. I think we're fine. Let's put the lid back on. And the unit is installed. These are the Drobo apps. You can install apps, of course, and see a remote solution, Drupal access, file sync, all kinds of stuff. Maybe I'm going to make a new share test speed. Speed test. Make a new user for it. Okay, this the speed test mount of is it mounted, and now I'm going to start up the Blackmagic speed test, and I'm going to do a project file and start. It's connected via 1 gigabit port, so this is the fastest it can do with the mSATA speed up 128 gigs. Now for I'll stop it. This is probably what it does. Read speeds are obviously always faster than the write speeds. Now let's me take a local drive. It's a 4 terabyte hard drive. I'm not sure what the rotations per minute is, but it's faster than the Drupal, as you can see.